live at the Lazy Lizard, Kirk and Marianne. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Jamal Lewis. Make some noise!
Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, man.
Thanks for that. I appreciate
you
that.
You know it, dude.
I had that many screens in a long time.
You are Ravens royalty, and everywhere you go, people know. I mean, you're one of the guys that carried a rock like a big dog.
I appreciate it. It was a good time.
How's the weather treating you out here? Nice?
Oh, man, it's great. I think every year I come, it's different weather. So this is good. This is beach weather here.
I'm going to ask you, like I asked Leach, are you a pool guy or the beach?
I'm more of a pool guy.
Two for two.
Beach is a little dirty for me.
I think pools are kind of dirty, too.
Yeah. I just hang out on the side.
Hey, when you had a big contract, did you build a house?
I built the whole subdivision.
Did you? Took care of everybody. That's cool. Yeah. Did you have any nice amenities like a big garage or an elevator in the house, anything cool like that?
It was just regular. Just regular, yeah. I just put some nice stuff in the garage.
Right,
that was my decoration.
Yeah. Hey, your thoughts on the Ravens and the path that they're taking towards 2017?
I think it's good, man. You can always depend on Ozzie. I think last year wasn't the best for us or whatever, but, you know, playing in a tough conference, you know, you gotta compete. You got to go in the draft and find what you need. And, you know, and I think Ozzie has done a good job of that in the past. And he know what he got to do. So, and we're Ravens, you know. We're a good team, great organization, so we're not going to be down for long.
Do you ever find that the players now call you up and ask for any advice, or is it just like they listen to their coach now?
Yeah, they don't want any advice from me. They know it all half the time.
Yeah.
But at the same time, you know, they just depend on their coaches, man. The game has changed so much.
New rules, yeah.
Yeah, all the time. I wouldn't know what to tell them, you know. I think if I told them something, it would be probably from what we did in the early 2000s. But the game has changed, you know, and it always evolves. So,
what about off the field? Any advice as far as life? I mean, your life changes so much,
oh,
right?
Yeah. Oh,
you know you could give some advice there,
I can
right?
definitely give you some off the field advice. But, you know, it's just with these kids nowadays, it's just different. You got a lot of social media. You know, they're brought up different or whatever, but the best thing you can do is just be humble, stay hungry, work on your craft, know what's important, and, you know, just know that there's life after football, so you got to carry yourself in a certain manner.
If I was Terrence West or Kenneth Dixon or one of those guys and Jamal Lewis was walking around, I might want to see how he's able to get to 2,000 yards in a season.
Yeah, that's hard work, man. It's just hard work and dedication, you know. Now, when I was growing up, you know, we stopped going on vacations when I got in the 7th or 8th grade. You
yep.
know, it was all about football. It was all about training and everything else. And the same way now, you got to know what's important. I knew that the game don't last long. So,
right.
you know, I retired when I was 30. So, you know, I can enjoy and do a lot of vacationing and do all that stuff then, because you never know when that last snap is going to happen.
Whew. Wish I could have retired at 30.
I know.
I got a ways to go. I might retire
by 80.
Yeah,
but he's probably limping a little bit more.
That's all right. I limp, too. I might limp, too. All right. 3-1, Jamal Lewis. Appreciate you stopping by and enjoy the fans. They're trying to take selfies and throw hugs.
Hey, it's always good to see you guys.
I want an autograph.
All right.